Everybody, it's Invicta. It's time for another Eden Run here, the Binding of Isaac Victa Repentance series. Happy Sunday, Mosh Pit. I hope your weekends were awesome and the new week is starting great for you. Once again, thank you all very much for the patience and understanding with last week's videos and me having to care for my dad. I did post an update to that on Twitter as well, which we'll talk about in a moment. But first, here's your meme of the day brought to you by Rapline. Title thread was Celeste is a dedicated member of the Mosh Pit. She stays very focused on the episodes. Oh, cat memes. It's been a while since we had an IRL cat meme, but yep, that's a cat watching some Isaac. I love it. Thank you very much, Rapline, and everyone who upvoted that one. Hop on into this here Eden run and get her done. Starting off with Duality and Jello. C-Day is going to be one Bravo X-Ray Juliet ganks. We've got crazy hair. Duality, oh, Curse the Blind 2 is neat. And yeah, Satanic Bible is... You know, Satanic Bible is not what we want to start with here. Oh, wow. I'm just now realizing how horrible our tears rate is. And honestly, like, nothing really good to start off with here. Except our HP, I guess. Yeah, 2.7. Yo, bro, back off me. There you go. 2.67 damage is not what I would say is conducive with a good start here. The shot speed is also just, ugh. And, yeah, the tears rate, 2.10 is pretty bad. I mean, we've seen worse tears rates for sure, but as far as starts go, this is pretty rough. At least the movement speed is somewhat okay. 1.07, it's maneuverable. But early on here, yeah, we're gonna have a rough go of things. But I posted on Twitter a couple days ago. Actually, I think it was on Wednesday I posted it. Papa Victa is feeling better. He's not like 100% better, and you know, which is that's obviously it's going to take some time. But he is feeling better, and he's, you know, he's up and about and moving, and you know, and able to kind of get stuff that he needs for himself again. But I did show him the thread that I made and all the YouTube comments that people have been sending him, and he texted me a little response that I posted on Twitter again. And, you know, just want to say thank you very much. He basically, to summarize it, he just said thank you to all of my followers who were sending him well wishes and good spirits and that sort of thing. So he really appreciated it. And I appreciate it, too. Thank you for making him feel better because he was in bad shape. It was a little scary there for a little while. But thankfully, he turned the corner and he kept getting better and better. So, you know, fingers crossed that he's going to be back at 100%. Soon, and you know, I won't have to have any interruptions and stuff in the videos. I know that that's not the important thing, and it's not the important thing. The important thing was taking care of him, but I still have a job to do as well. So, you know, just having an audience that's so cool and so understanding, you know, to support what I do, but also be supportive of my family is really awesome. So, thank you all very much for that and the understanding as well. But the reason why we're not using Satanic Bible right now is because we do not want to usurp our regular boss drop with a Devil Deal item. And on top of that, we do not want our boss drop to cost us HP because we don't have a whole lot of HP right now. And we'd rather save it for a true blue Devil Deal. These hearts are interesting, though, because we do have movement speed upgrade. We would have a couple of taps on the sacrifice room, not enough to really make that much of progress, but it'd be interesting if we get a couple more hearts out of here, then we're in business. And we did not. So what we can do now is we can tap essentially 4.5 times and hope that we get maybe a chest or something. But this, as you see, this tears rate is going to be pretty rough. We get one coin. Okay. The coin. I am going to take these other hearts now, and the reason why this isn't really much of a danger is basically because of the Satanic Bible. We know that we're going to be able to leave with a half red heart plus a black soul heart. That should be enough to keep us safe throughout the next floor, and which is obviously going to be key because then we can get the Devil Deal and hopefully get ourselves some good old offense. But the Satanic Bible, it's such a risk because you don't really like having, or at least I don't really like having my boss drops being taken over by a buy a devil deal item. You know, when on the initial release of Repentance, and we saw that change in the Satanic Bible, I myself was like, oh my God, this is incredible. Like, getting guaranteed devil deals when we don't need to have a devil deal, we don't need to qualify for it, it's awesome. But at the bigger picture, and you start thinking about how important boss items are, and losing those stat ups, those guaranteed, well, almost guaranteed stat ups that you can get, it's kind of a tall order. It really is to want to say, hey, we don't want any more boss drops. We don't want any more boss items. All we want is devil deals. It's not sustainable. It's unrealistic, I would say, to expect yourself to get nothing but stat ups from devil deals. And on top of that, remember, you're also losing HP. Really kind of hoping that we're going to see some hearts here. We just need one more tap to get a chance to get an angel deal item. Despite this being Curse of the Blind. Now, again, I know that we could simply just use the Satanic Bible now and then hit the sacrifice room and pray. But the problem is that we need the soul heart to survive on the next floor, possibly. Maybe even in this room, to be honest, because these Claudies, with this shot speed and this angle of this room, it really sucks. So we're just going to take it easy. Bot's killing me. Getting in the way of every single shot. Come on now. There we go. All right. First floor entrance for the store is free, and our shops continue to be... Well, I guess we can't really see what's in that shop, but... Okay, so we have a 33% chance to teleport to the angel room. We get there, and it's Eden Soul. Eden Soul is not great, but I'm going to take it because we essentially sacrificed we sacrificed Boss Rush, really, is what it comes down to. So Eden Soul is going to give us two items in whatever item pool that we use it in, as far as the room is concerned, but it's going to take a while before we charge it. Curse the Lost. But now the question becomes, where do we use Eden Soul? Well, we already have duality, meaning that we can guarantee that we can use it inside of an angel deal, which I think is a better use of it than using it in a devil deal. Or potentially we could also be using it inside of a secret room, which may be giving us, you know, one of the best items in the game in the form of Rock Bottom. I'm actually going to take Headless Baby here, not because I'm doing a 180 on my opinion of Conjoined, but because we need damage right now. We immediately get into a room where we cannot damage the most dangerous enemies that we could see at the beginning. So, another thing with Headless Baby that we have to be careful of is the fact that its creep it overrides enemy creep, so it makes it very difficult to see where our creep starts and where the enemy creeps begins and that sort of thing. Need to get a bomb here for this here Tinted Rock. Should try to go into the shop if we can, because if they have a bomb, that one bomb opens up a world of possibilities here for us. But getting a bomb is kind of imperative here, and also getting a creep out like that is a good way to deal with enemies that just simply walk around Isaac. Big double heart drop too. We do get a bomb, so now we don't need to go into the shop. This bomb is important because we can get this bomb here. I don't think it's going to get the key, though, but get this bomb. Then get this Tinted Rock and still have a bomb left over for the Secret Room or Super Secret Room. And we get two Soul Hearts. So now we have to make a big boy decision. Where do we go from here? Do we go after the Angel Room for Eden Soul? It's not even charged yet, so it's not really that much of not that big of a deal, but we still have a decision to make. Do we go for devil deals or do we go for angel deals here? Now again, we have duality, so we are not beholden to whatever decision we make here. We could start off with an angel deal and then go to a devil deal if we really, really wanted to. Look at that damage from Headless Baby. Some good DPS right there. We get some damage. Let's go angel. And we get Monstrance, which... yeah, that's kind of doo-doo. Oh, Kurt. Whoops. Oh, hey. Whoa there, water bottle. Water bottle hit the keyboard. Fell over. Luckily, the cap was on. The Monstrance, I mean, it gives us a source of passive damage. Is it good passive damage? No. No, not really, because our base damage is kind of low. Getting Glass Eye definitely helps out. But Monstrance at least doesn't slow down the projectiles that are coming towards you, which might sound counterintuitive, but you have to remember like how bad Nightlight is and Sensor to be like, oh yeah, that's actually pretty good. So Monstrance just gives us this light aura that has two stages around Isaac. The outer ring is going to be able to produce the weakest amount of damage over time, but obviously it's the easiest to inflict, whereas the inner ring does more damage. I don't know what the percentages are, so don't ask me. Another nice thing about Monstrance, though, compared to, like, say... wow, that was a crazy dodge. Compared to, say, Headless Baby, is the fact that it does hit enemies on the ground and in the air. So it's any enemies around Isaac, regardless if they're terrestrial or aerial. I knew that was going to happen. We might as well fight the boss since we're here. Eden Soul is about to be charged up. So we can use Eden Soul for two angel items or devil deal items. I mean, devil deal items honestly like are looking pretty good considering that we need damage. Or we could go the unsafe route, the gamble route, and go for the secret room. Or even better, if you want to go the ultimate safest route, hey, use it inside of a boss room. You know, you're guaranteed to get either HP or stats, so it's not a bad play, but it's definitely not the sexy play, I'll say that. That's not the play that I think that people will get much excitement out of. Or we just don't get a devil deal or angel deal. So now, well, thankfully we did get a nice tiers up here with the screw. Secondly, we have to make a decision on if we find the secret room, which we probably will on this floor, do we use Eden Soul inside of there? Instead of waiting for an angel deal, which may not actually happen until floor five. It's definitely a dilly of a pickle to be in, because you know, going for secret room items has not proven to be all that successful in the past. When we've had Eden Soul or when we've had magic skin or anything like that. Oh, but a Perthro rune kinda changes that. A Perthro rune gives us four choices of item pedestals. Now, because you have to remember the reroll is going to reroll the pedestals, and that'd be that. Of course, we're going the super long way to just find the item room. This is what we want. So I have no idea where the secret room is currently. We also could potentially use the Perthro rune when we get into the angel deal. For the reroll. This is like the most obnoxious possible placement for these things. What I'm showing you here is curving your shots. You can stay there all you want. It's just going to take us a while to kill you because you know, you're just being a jerk at this point. But this is a technique that you want to get used to and you want to get good at doing as well. You know, going for the curvature shots are very important. Is a disappointment. Hallowed Ground's not bad, but it goes away as soon as you shoot it accidentally. But I think the plan here, since the secret room is not obvious, I think the plan should be, let's just wait. Super secret room might be south of there. Let's just wait until the next floor. I'm going to take a stab for it here. Okay, it is there. No money. I'm still going to wait. The reason why I'm going to wait is because we might as well go to the next secret room and see if we can spawn a reroll machine inside of there so we're not forced to use the Perth Row, but instead we can reroll via our money. But now, here's another thing. This is another piece of this equation. I don't like this. Another piece of this equation here is, do we use... Again, let this be a lesson in how important it is to controlling your output damage, which is the reason why I don't think Monstrance is actually a good item at all. Your damage output is not in your control except where you move, and sometimes you get trapped and, you know, that's it. So another thing to keep in mind in this whole conundrum that we're kind of sailing into right now, is that we could use this Eden Soul into an Angel Deal, and then with the Perth Row Room we can also potentially reroll those. So, you know, let's see if there is a reroll machine inside of the secret room first. Not, but there's a charge key, which doesn't matter. We can get into the first room as well as the boss trap room. We get the mark, which is fantastic. This is one of three of Leviathan, also gives us damage and movement speed and a soul heart. I'm not going to use our last bomb right now to get into the boss trap room, mainly because I don't want to go fight a boss yet. Camo undies again. And we also may need this bomb for something else. The camo undies was definitely the all-star standout the last time that we had it. And thankfully in this spot, we're not in as much of a dire strait as we were the last time that we saw camo undies, but... got another bomb here, it's good. I'm going to drop a bomb just so we can get up to our coveted 73%. The camo undies is going to stealth Isaac, do a little AoE damage, like, I don't know, decloaking, whatever you want to call it, like this. And then he gets a kidney stone-esque type level of tears for very, very brief window of time after coming out of stealth. Rotten hearts here. I will take all rotten hearts because it is nice having the combined efforts of the stealth nature of camo undies along with the flies just to, you know, finish stuff off. And of course, in true Invicta fashion, we fail a 73% deal with the devil. Or deal with the angel. So, we once again wait till floor 5 before we can do anything with our starting item. But we can still go over here, bomb our way into the boss trap room, and get ourselves the box. It's not worth it. Honestly, yes, we might get a soul heart, but it could also just be a red heart, and we get a trinket and a key and a bomb, but it's not worth it. It's just not in this spot, I don't think. If we were any stronger, I'd say sure, but in this spot, I honestly think it's not worth our time. Okay, as long as we didn't get Curse of the Blind, I'm not going to be that upset. I'm still kind of... still kind of pissed that it took us to floor 5 to get us here, because we have duality and that's... and this Perthor rune and Eden Soul, which is like so many possibilities early on. But now, it's kind of devolved into a, well, at least we'll get something for it, but it took long enough. No. So we can come away with a bunch of bombs here for the cost of two keys. And that is definitely worth it. Okay, so now we're just swimming in bombs. My favorite Fall Out Boy record. I actually don't like Fall Out Boy at all. I like the character from The Simpsons, but man, I do not like the band. Catch Five Poops a day late and a dollar short, but hey, maybe we'll get a dollar for it. I mean, honestly, having Petrified Poop and Hallowed Ground is not the worst combo. You can get the occasional Eternal Hearts out of there. But right now, this singular key needs to be used in the Tienda more than anywhere. I'm honestly surprised that the Demon Fires can even target Isaac. So we get our second Yave. And let Monstrous do its thing. Because, I mean, technically, enemies shouldn't be able to see us. The Soul Heart back for our troubles, and we also find the shop. Surprisingly had a somewhat outside shot at getting Boss Rush, and it's another Greek fight. So we might as well bomb these for 6 cents. Two bombs for 12 cents is a really good deal. So that's, of course, assuming that we actually get a store to use the money in. And at last, our long-awaited maybe angel deal. Maybe? I say maybe because there's a possibility that it may not even spawn. This room actually it I don't think it is going to spawn in this room, so we have to hope that we do get an angel deal instead of a devil deal. Angel deals with rerolls are just so much better. Speed upgrade. I mean, even Succubus is not really worth it here. All right, well, I guess the play is going to be use the Eden Soul. Use it inside of a secret room, I guess, because now that's looking like it's only going to be our option, because... there's nothing wrong with Succubus, of course. People are going to look at this and be like, what's wrong with Succubus? How come he didn't take Succubus? There's nothing wrong with Succubus. The only thing wrong with Succubus in this situation is that we don't have enough we do not have enough HP to be safe with this current damage. To just be giving up all of our HP. I don't know where the secret room is here. We know it can't be to the left of here, and it can't. It might be south of here, maybe. It'd be a weird spot for it. It'd be here, but again, that's another weird spot for it. It might be in the elbow of the library L. Bookworm transformation. Have a key, so we can't get in this golden chest. Now we can. Please be an item. Not an item. It's a half soul heart. Battle mushroom and greed's gullet. Yikes. Reroll it into glitch crown and inner child, which mean, it's an extra life for sure. Glitch Crown, on the other hand, is not one of my favorite items, despite a whole lot of people really liking Glitch Crown, and for some odd reason, like, is becoming people's favorite go-to death certificate item. I think it's an annoying item. Now, that being said, I am always the one who says that more opportunity in Isaac is a good thing, and that is true. And the Glitch Crown definitely gives you more opportunity, but it can also completely screw you. If your timing is off, then just forget about it. It's a very difficult, it's an unwieldy item, to say the least. If you don't know what Glitch Crown does, well, ask me when we see our first item room. Or item pedestal at that point. Okay, so there's the north and the east side of the map. I think it'd be cool if the chargers, when they ran into each other, they just like just offed each other instead of, you know, going through each other. I wonder where that concussive effect is coming from. Unless there's black poop over there that I didn't see. We have the Healy champion. We're at 99 cents because just have not had anything to spend our money on. Pinted skull. It's like every room we get a very brief window. So yeah, so that's what Glitch Crown does. I mean, Brittle Bones almost is the go-to here. I love Sulfuric Acid, don't get me wrong, but Brittle Bones, we need the tears up. And that right there is the reason why I hate Glitch Crown.
Oh, but you can escape and you can pause it.
So we get the Eternal D6 instead of the item that I wanted. We really needed. Might as well play Judgment here. Piercing shots would be nice. Thank you, little chest. Glad you're here. And we finally get to go to our store. Let's go see what our money can buy us. All right. I mean, honestly, give me the candle at this point. Just give me the candle. Might as well buy this because another judgment. Okay, good. I honestly just want the HP upgrade at this point. Yeah, he's done it. We got one successful item pedestal here. Okay, so we could play... Well, we need to get the Polaroid first before we decide to play the Demon Judgment. Requires us getting our Tinted Skull. I do not remember where that was. I swore it was down here. Am I going crazy? Might be going crazy. There it is. Okay. Just not worth the keys. The blue mom here. Monster just makes it very difficult to see where the mom shadow is coming from. Oh, this is a super stompy mom. Left hand. Yeah, we're gonna take the Polaroid here. Get AWAS. Can't possibly fail this. How you doing, little sissy? Little sissy, you already knew which one we were going to be going for. Little sissy long legs. Can't tell when our shield is off or not, so I'm going to go get another red heart container. Little sissy. Showing up in our time of need. All right, now we're on a roll. Now we're cooking. Yeah, we were done with that. Honestly, I'll take the left hand. Okay. Yeah, man, this whole reason why we took left hand. There's 9 lives right there. Assuming that we don't bung up the glitch crown. This, I can guarantee you that this was supposed to be 9 lives. 9 lives was the original item that we were supposed to get here, so. Come on, sissy. Sorry. The damage of monstrance and blue candle. Okay. Okay, game. Dead cat, 9 lives, get a hermit card, and hell, why not?
The hermit.
Appreciate it, little chest. Glad you're here. We definitely really, really wanted you on the team. Monstrance is like, it's a distracting item, you know? Like it masks a lot of things that the game tries to do. For money. All right, 78% chance for deal with the angel or deal with the devil. Most likely probably deal with the devil. Fine, because we could use guppy items. I'm too quick for you, Mama Gertie. You do finally get an angel deal. Out of 9 tails, and I mean, Revelation would be fine with me just for the flying at this point. You get Revelation. The angel statue key will not turn in, it's not affected by Glitch Crown because it's a quest item. All right. By the grace of Little Sissy, we're now moving. Look at that. We're getting ourselves a half soul heart randomly. I tell you what. The blue candle is being used here to supplement our damage and essentially just give us shutdown potential on bosses. It can also be used defensively to block shots, of course, which is another very good use of it. But its main role in a run like this is to simply provide us with damage. And now that we have Revelation, obviously, Blue Candle is going to take a little bit of a backseat here. But still can prove to be very useful. We're going to go for the Relic here. Relic is going to be pretty good. Pretty good. Give us some extra soul hearts just for some insurance. And we have gone the wrong way. That would have given us the eye or the head of greed. We would have been able, or head of the keeper, I should say. It would have been affected by the glitch crown, and that would have been nice. Take care of the Az. I was hoping to sneak a hit against Mom there. Now, what's nice about Revelation is that we don't have to... We essentially do not have to stop charging it to fire a blue candle, which is good. And we didn't get an Angel Deal or Devil Deal, which is unfortunate, but not expected. Not unexpected. On the home stretch now, and we just got to do it. I think the left hand is probably going to get dropped when we go to the chest, maybe. The reason why I'm going to hold on to it for now is mainly because I want more HP and also the chance of getting another Guppy item. You can expect those blorbs. They'll always spawn right on top of you. Don't worry. They're programmed to do. And a rock over here. There's a red chest, which had nothing in it. Starscar, I'll probably end up using for the chest for the random teleport. All right. There is the entire map. Let's go to the right side, shall we? Yeah, we were very worried about Papa Victor there for a while. Yep, there you go. But thankfully he got some good help, good doctors, and he was able to get past all the nastiness of the Backstreet Boys reunion tour. Yeah, this room while charging Revelation is a little bit of a nightmare. I'm glad that we at least get flying from it. Yep, there's this. Other side of the map here. Let's go to the real side of the map, shall we? One thing to remember is that we do have Glitch Crown, so it may behoove us to actually stick with the red hand, or the left hand, I should say, for the red chests inside the chest. Because those could potentially give us Guppy as well.
Here's the entire east side of the map. Now let's really go to the right side and go finish off this map to the boss, shall we? Yeah. All right.
The Hierophant. Damn right, I'm gonna get my hearts back. Tired of this. Tired of seeing this cathedral. Use a blue candle there defensively. Yeah, I think this might be the last time that we take Monstrance. If I wish that there was a way to just change the way that it looked. Make it just like, I don't know how I would change it. Make the field maybe invisible that you have around it. It really is. I've never really noticed how distracting Monstrance can be. I'm gonna stick with the left hand. We're going to see if we can get Guppy, if we can get a slam dunk Guppy here. Slam dunk Sunday. Yeah. 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 Did not get Guppy. Wow, this is rough. Big SMB super fan. Take Proptosis and I guess Sack Dagger. The other one I honestly don't even care about. Get Proptosis, which is going to help out our Revelation damage a lot. No huge tiers up though, outside of SMB Superfan, which is not even that great of a tiers up. There's a good tiers up though. Getting the cancer trinket. Two hearts would give us a full double the amount of hearts that we heal, basically. Kind of like a full heal almost if you time it right with the amount of hearts. But obviously we have no red hearts, so. I think that if you have only soul hearts and you get a two of hearts, I think it should give you two soul hearts. Is that too much to ask? Is that too powerful? I went straight to blue baby. There we go. So that is going to be it, everybody. Thank you very much. Once again, one final time for all the patience and support for this past week. This run was, that's funny, game. It certainly was. This run certainly was. But hey, at least we got Revelation. We got to see some Glitch Crown. But the most important thing is that we got Little Sissy. And thank you for liking, commenting, subscribing, everyone. If you enjoyed this episode, make sure you click the like button. Really would appreciate it. Get over 3,000 likes and continue the like streak as we keep on getting closer to our like streak goal of the lost week and counting. Thank you again, everyone, for all the support. And as always, I'll see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody. Thanks for watching this video. I'd like to thank some patrons of mine like Kalen Poirier, Bailey Fox, Abdul Aziz Al Hamad, Daniel Horowitz, and Nathan. If you'd like to have your name read at the end of an Isaac episode, check out my Patreon campaign, which you can find by going to patreon.com/Sinvicta.